Hello Internet! Did you ever wonder about how to test for blood types? If you haven't already seen my video about the blood types, I would recommend doing so first and to come back later. I'll still be here, I promise. So the usual blood typing for ABO and Rh is pretty straightforward. First, we need a blood sample to test and a sample card with a serum of antibodies. Just put a drop of blood on each field and if the cells begin to stick together, they are reacting with the antibodies. This test can include the Rh factor. It just needs to have a positive and negative field for each ABO type. From this test alone, you can already determine your blood type. Simply compare the result with a chart. If you have, for example, type A, your blood should get destroyed by field B and O. And this test is a very easy solution to the problem. But especially with the Rh factor, it's not very practical. So there is an even better, yet similar way of blood typing. This time we only need 4 fields to test ABO, Rh, and even to check if the test is valid or not. The first field got antibody A, the second antibody B, the third antibody D, and the last one no antibodies at all, but the same phosphate buffer as the rest. This means, if the control field starts to agglutinate, the whole test is invalid and has to be redone. An agglutination in field A means you got antigen A on your blood cells, resulting in type A or AB. An agglutination in field B, on the other hand, confirms antigen B, so it is either type B or AB. A reaction with antibody D shows you the Rh factor. If it agglutinates, the sample is Rh positive. And this is all we need to know to create a chart. Let's fill it out for each type. Type O does not have antigen A or B, so it won't get affected by antibody A or B. Type A cells agglutinate in field A, but not B. Type B cells agglutinate in field B, but not A, and type AB got both antigens, so both fields A and B starts agglutinating. To determine the Rh factor, we look at field D. If the sample agglutinates, it is Rh positive, if not, then negative. And of course, everything is only valid as long as the control field stays intact. This is definitely a better system than the ones before, but still, only testing in one direction. We need a little bit more accuracy. I mean, it's pretty important information. So there is the so-called backtyping. This time, we're focusing on your antibodies. And they get mixed with blood cells of a particular type. If you really have type A, then that should destroy the blood cells of B and AB, since you have anti-B in your blood. And well, this is all. Like I said, pretty straightforward. Thanks to Sixto for the question. But what did you ever wonder about? Write it in the comments and your idea could be the topic of a future video. And with that being said, thanks for watching. Have a good one.